Next, we have in line the concept tutor, mentored by Mrs. Madhulika Goyal and managed by Mr. Rahul Deshmukh, sir. The app focuses on learning of concepts through educational games. So let's have the gaming on. The team is here, so let's start with the presentation.
So good morning to one and all. I am Vishesh Kandhari, and together with my teammates, I'll be giving a brief description of our project, which is titled as Concept Tutor. Yeah, so the main objective of this project was to basically develop educational applications that would enable the user to understand the concepts of some particular subject. And the subject that we are focused on is social studies, which under which we have covered civics as well as geography. So basically, we have made two games for this. The motivation behind this project was that there are plenty of applications available on the Android market that focus on subjects like mathematics and science. However, there's a lack of Indianized and localized applications which focus on subjects like social sciences. And there's a reason for that. Most of the applications are developed by developers from UK or US and other Western countries. And they create the application according to their own constitution, according to their own localized content. So there was a need of application which focused on content in the Indian context. And that is what we have tried to achieve in that project. The technology that we have used for developing the games is Unity Gaming Engine. These are two important technical concepts which I'll be giving a brief description about. One of them is colliders and another is raycasting. Now, colliders are basically components that we attach to gaming objects inside the gaming engine. And these colliders are basically allow the objects to detect collisions with each other. Similar to the concept of real bodies colliding. So in gaming engine, if you want to detect collision between game objects, we attach colliders to them. Second concept is known as ray casting, which is basically the process of emitting rays, virtual rays, from a particular specified point in all the directions or in any direction that we have specified. Using these two basic concepts, we have developed six types of interactions which we are using in our games, which are touch to select, drag to move, drag to draw, drag and drop, pinch to zoom, and scroll. So these gestures have been used in all the in both the games that we have developed. We'll be straight away jumping to the demonstration because that is going to take a lot of time. Okay, this is the civics game. It starts with create the village scene basically. Here the user is given a basic set of components using which he or she can make his own village. So example, you have to place some houses, trees and stuff. So this is the first thing. Okay, the second module is the election module. Here we are basically trying to simulate the process of election of the Gram Panchayat for the village which the user has created. So this we are divided into various sections. The first section is shortlisting the candidates on the basis of citizenship. Because according to the Indian constitution, only Indian candidates are eligible for the election. So that is what the user is supposed to do here. The second scene involves shortlisting the candidates on the basis of age. According to the Indian constitution, candidates of age 21 years or above are eligible for contesting in elections. Actually, the images which are displaying, they are not showing the ages properly because the resolution is a bit low. So it's not getting really visible. But what's happening is every candidate is displayed in the bottom bar with his or her age. So these quadrants, I'm sorry, I didn't explain this. These quadrants are basically wards. We have divided the entire village into different wards. The election procedure takes place in the form of wards. So first,
okay, all right, go ahead.
The third one is basically matching the candidates with their entries inside the electoral list. So here we are simulating that the candidate goes to his or her ward's office, and in the electoral list, they match whether their entry is there or not. In the first scene, only we have all the walls and we have candidates placed. So, yes, sir. So that in the second scene, we get again placing them in the respective wards to show that these candidates belong to these wards. That is why. Okay, now the fourth scene actually simulates the actual election procedure, the actual voting process. For the voting, we have basically implemented a random generation algorithm, which randomly distributes the votes of each and every ward among the candidates who are standing for election in that ward. So for example, in the first ward, we have first candidate has got 37 votes, second candidate has got 166 votes. So in this way, we are dividing the votes among the candidates. Now, what the user is supposed to do is, after the votes have been divided, the user has to select all the candidates from each ward who has a majority. So that is how we are simulating the election procedure.
No, first of all, I don't know how the user magically knows what he has to do.
Actually, sir, we are proceeding a little bit fast, but we are getting instructions in the beginning of each and every level. We are skipping that particular portion because we want to
that white thing was instruction.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay.
Ward number are not significant out here. Basically, what we basically wanted to do is each and every candidate is looking different from others. So what we have done is we have basically given 7 slots. So if you select a particular candidate, you know that this candidate is already selected. Like from this ward, a candidate has already been selected. So that is because the ward numbers are not really significant in our game. Basically, we want to describe, make the user understand the concept that the election takes place in terms of wards. Which ward is named as ward is really not important.
Which standard is this related to?
6th standard. Basically, we have followed textbook, the state government textbook of 6th standard.
State government textbook?
Yes, sir. An NCERT book of 8th standard. We have researched to multiple textbooks, and we have actually different boards have taught these subjects in different standards. So NCERT has this in 8th standard, and Maharashtra State Board has this in 6th standard. So we have used the textbooks of both of them, and we have implemented this.
Okay.
The object. Yes, sir. Because we want the user to understand that once the election is like, we want them to understand the majority concept. Okay, the random generation. It shows the elected members.
Actually, what is happening? We have criteria for elections. You should be citizen. You should be under above age of 21. You should be in the electronics or voter list. So those three criteria they have taken and they are dividing. So each the 7 members will go in respect to what gender. They will never go because they put the coding in such a way that they will always remain in their ward. They cannot go in another ward.
But it is also a good suggestion that you should have given the ward numbers because election happen with the ward numbers.
Things which are only limited to certain concepts of whether it be linked and non-person related. If such points don't establish that there are many wards in the region, you do that at the ward level.
One ward, single ward.
No, because then the sarpanch is there. Then the again next sarpanch is also there. We have to elect a sarpanch.
And then that time, that can even zoom out and say that okay, there are similar wards even for me, which will come to even say there is a village. Right now, this interactivity is
No, I don't agree with this whole thing. Okay, I think the concept is excellent. There is no doubt about it. Okay, I am not looking at it as an election. I am looking at it as a way to as a way for the student to assimilate. Assimilate is a word I use very frequently. Assimilate what is written. Okay, once I play this game, okay, the whole election process I should never forget. It's a way of branding it in my memory. So that way is good. Okay. But if that is your objective, okay, you have not achieved it. Okay. You have to start with an objective. There are too many things which do not matter. Okay. And you are not allowing mistakes. Okay. People learn from mistakes.
We can demonstrate that.
Okay. No, wait. Again, I am not sure whether in this particular process, okay, any interaction is required, okay, because the interaction is probably only going to slow it down, okay. It could be a sort of a, automated random, okay, random automated animation, okay. While a child goes in to register, finds his name not there in the voting list, all those kind of problems which are not there in the book, okay, should come out. All right, but that has to be random. Why should only he makes a mistake, he learns it, I don't make a mistake, I don't learn. Why it should be left to that? Okay, concept is excellent. I'm sure you have put in a lot of effort, okay, but my reading is I know you are spending too much time on it.
Yes,
okay. Yes, you have done it as a technologist. Yeah. You have not done it from the point of view of the student. What he should get out of it, how much time he should spend on it. The end objective has to be something sitting in his brain, not moving people around. Till I make a mistake and discover that below 25 cannot do. Okay. Suppose by mistake he doesn't want to spend too much time. He says, I'll take two candidates. Both of them are valid. How will he learn? Okay. That is what I was saying. Okay. There are some things where interaction is a must. Okay. Where I can change the age of the candidate and try. That kind of experimentation is a good learning. In this particular process learning, I think animation is probably the thing to go. But very, very good job. Show me the next one.
Yes, sir. Thank you. So that its significance will come.
No, that was completely out of tune and useless. Okay. Build our own village is just to make it, quote, interesting. That's what I think.
Yeah, even I think that.
Correct. But it is not necessary.
It is a warm-up. It is to bring the person to it.
But if that warming up is going to exhaust all my calories.
Okay. So actually, there is a reason why we put the Create the Village scene. Actually, followed by the election, after the election, basically have a set of issues. Because the user has to... yes, sir.
The quiz at the end is fine. Quiz at the end is fine. Okay. I have no problem. It's an interactive session which runs automatically. Do the quiz at the end. Allow him to go back and find the answer. Absolutely no problem. Learning with the... Your methodology is correct. Your everything is correct. You have put lot of things which are unnecessary for the main objective of process. Head kabhi nahi jana chahiye. Okay. For example, if I ask a question, the candidate has to be 25 years or more. What should stick in my mind is a child has walked in and he has been rejected. Okay. That is what will stick. The visual impression, who is rejected, let me find out. Okay. So that is the good of the visual medium. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So you built two, correct?
Yes, we have built two games.
Correct.
Actually,
you took some time to learn Unity.
Yes, sir.
How much time was that?
So 1 week for the theoretical learning. We spent another week for another 2 weeks for implementing all the 6 type of gestures, and then we developed each and every module using those gestures. Because
so
once
about 5 weeks for an animated game.
So yeah, 6 weeks.
Plus 2 plus 5.
No sir, we had more, like, because we have developed a geography game also. We have developed
but
many.
There are two of you, so one person is 5% week, the other person is 5% week.
Yes sir.
Other game. Okay, so let's go with geography.
So actually, we have many more puzzles that we have implemented in the civics game also. This is not the end of the civics game.
So, firstly, demonstrate.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Puzzles on the election process only, right?
After the election process has been, you can proceed with the demonstration. I'll explain that what in short. So after the election process.
Because okay. We have no time.
Please.
I want to see geography because I want to see how geography can be implemented.
Yeah. So this is the final. Please get this done with.
Again, this is out of scope.
This actually simulates the election.
I understand what it simulates.
Yes, sir.
Too much learning. Okay. I'm sure the book does not do this. At least in physics, chemistry, maths, it does not do this. Okay. Fiction is taught in standard 7 and standard 8.
Okay.
Not both together in standard 7. Okay. So similarly, your games have to be for standard 7, standard 8, separate.
After the election has been done, the user is presented with basically 9 types of issues, and you have to play these issues and solve these issues in the form of various games that we implemented. So this is first game. Just select one of the rule. Skip it. Skip. Yeah. Okay. This is in the form of multiple choice questions. You are given a question and 4 options. This is a very simple implementation of multiple choice questions. The questions are subject to the role that you have selected. For example, I want to play as a sarpanch. So you have to answer according to the sarpanch. So you will be given a scenario.
This is beyond the book, right?
Yes, sir. This is beyond the book. Yes, sir. We are not trying to completely go by the book. We are trying to, use and enhance.
No. You are right in a sense. You have to extend the book. Otherwise, there is no point in using it. Book has certain medium. Okay. How much? It depends on the brain of the child. Okay. Extending 20-30% below is definitely good. okay. Otherwise, it makes it uninteresting. Okay. Yeah. Next, next.
First was MCQ. Second one, please.
So that's okay. We understand there are a lot of quizzes. That's okay.
So I think we can move to the geography game.
Geography. Go to geography. I want to see how you teach geography.
The geography game generally revolves around the number of the different states.
This is my business. They are doing
geography game just revolves around different the states, the neighboring countries which form the Indian subcontinent, and the different physical terrains which are present in the in our country.
I already have this.
Yeah, so by taking
states
one,
and capitals,
taking obviously different modules one by one. First of all, the states and capitals one. We have three different levels for it. First of all, the easy one, in which you will be given the state name and you just need to drag and drop the image which pops up to the to its exact location, just like this. If you do it correctly, then it is given by a green feedback and the information regarding that states you can see directly that is coming on the over there. Now going on to the next question, if you just drag and drop it to your wrong position, so it will not increment your score and over there it's written that your answer is wrong and the information about the state over where you have taken it will come. So this is the implementation of the easy level. In the medium level, what we have done is we have just
move to the next game. Next game.
We have just taken the capital name and then you need to match it with the state and you need to drag and drop it in the same way it happens. Now going on to the final.
Go to capital,
just a second. Just a second. Please go back.
So in the capital one, only the name of the capital is displayed. Yeah. So and the state
is medium complexity. I don't understand. It's the same as before. No, I have to drop that particular shape into the proper thing. What has Hyderabad got to do with it?
It's generally like we are also making the student acquainted with the capital if they don't know, just to learn the capital.
No, but then they have to match Hyderabad with that. I have no problem. How when I do drag this, that particular drag option, okay, how does it imprint that knowledge in my brain through interaction?
The ideal interaction for this question would have been
where is Hyderabad? Or drop that Hyderabad, drag and drop to that particular thing.
Sir, actually, when we come to small cities like Hyderabad, the main problem is that we need to then do it for all the states
I
separately.
I have never cared about the technical problem, okay? Don't talk to me. Requirements are requirements.
Fine.
The requirement for an interactive tool to make the student understand which is the capital of which state is dragging the capital onto the state. It cannot be anything else. You cannot use dragging the same shape to learn something which is irrelevant. Okay.
Fine, sir. We will surely take it into consideration.
No, you are not going by what is the final requirement. Okay. Go next. This I already have anyway, I think.
And going on to the hard level, just a physical map of the country appears and the state is given. And now you need to drag and drop the state to its exact position. Like it's Sikkim, so we need to drag it to its position. If it's correct, then it will blink to green in color. Like this, we need to do it. And every time we are removing the previous state so that the complexity remains the same. Means for example, there are 10 questions. If we just keep on sticking the states over there, it will be easier and easier as we go by. So that's why we are removing the state of the previous level.
That's okay. Go next. I understand.
Now going to the neighboring countries one.
Is similar.
Identify the neighboring country.
It is similar.
Yeah, it means we
no,
just need
I,
to...
I don't understand. What is this?
Yeah, basically the user is given that mention or pinpoint this country. For example, pinpoint China. So, to click on China. This is a simple, very simple touch-based game. There is no drag and drop, nothing. Here the user has to... user is given with a map.
What you don't understand is you are trying to make countries and states different. It's geography. Okay. Then why you did not do it for states is the question I will ask. Drag and drop Maharashtra. Why that learning was not there? Okay. You have to say area wise, learning about area, I will use these techniques. Then I can externalize it to the world. Everything cannot be different. There is a mode of learning applied to the certain thing. That's why when you gave me civics, I tell you for processes, excellent method. Okay. It is to, has to be repeatable. I cannot keep thinking again and again. Okay, what is to be done? Okay, once you have done civics okay, properly, with proper learning, take any other process, the steps are same. Nothing. I don't have to think again. Alright. Yeah, neighboring countries done. Physical terrains.
So in the physical terrains one, we are giving a physical map and the question like you can see it asks you to draw the third desert. So we also have an option to zoom in. We can zoom in and then we have the pen tool, and over here we need to draw the Thar desert. So it
draw
will
what?
The Thar desert. For example, the user gave draw the Thar desert on the map.
Achha.
So you will draw
on the top that appears that draw the Thar desert. So using the pen tool, we need to draw it wherever we think that it is present, and then we need to click on the done button. First of all, it will showcase you to the exact answer. Then again, it will show your score, that how much it score. For example, how we implemented this was by dividing.
That is ridiculous. Forget it. What is 9.33? What will I do with it?
Basically, this gives the percentage or the fraction
you
of
have,
the current.
Have you seen my thumb?
Pansum?
I am very bad at drawing. You will give me less marks all the time. I can't even press that soft keyboard. It's very difficult for me. If I type Q, it goes to W. I have not tried with my thumb. It will go completely crazy. Correct. Okay, good, good.
Okay,
so understand this. So you're using the pen technology.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
So wrapping this entire thing is, like you said, we had some flaws in the basis of the concept, on the basis of the content. Now, because of this, as being a technical people, what we are trying to develop and what we are trying to develop in future is to develop each of these modules as a generic and dynamic module. The content will be up to the user to add. So example, we'll be developing the entire game in such a way that any instructor can use our application, input all the content, all the images as he or she likes, and the game will adapt to the content. For example, instead of in the states thing, for example, the concept which we used identify the states, we can change that concept for the user
exactly
to
identify. That's what I told you in neighboring.
Yes, sir. So that is what we have been aiming at, and that's what we also aim to do in future. So we are basically focusing more on the technical aspect. These are just examples of how our modules can be used in various scenarios. This is just
I'm
one
just
scenario.
Looking at it for like that only.
Yes, sir. So in
I would not have used, if I had a pen, I would not have used Thar Desert. I would have used Godavari River. Okay, that's a much better use of a pen.
Yes, sir.
And why the pen is so thick?
So we can actually
you
go
can
for the Thar Desert. So we have different.
Correct. Basically, that is the knowledge that children should have, and they will learn. Godavari starts here. Where does it go?
Yes,
with C. Approximate direction. That's all that is required.
That is exactly what we have developed this module. So you can put your own content. And it will
and
adapt.
You cannot say 90%, it's 100% correct. If it starts at this point and ends here, reasonably accurate, that is the knowledge I am supposed to have. Okay. Needed by the geography book.
Yes, sir.
Godavari originates in this state and ends in this state. These are the questions that we need to do. Passes through so many states. Which are the people who fight over Godavari? Kaveri is the best example. Okay, good.
Thank you.